climbed every mountain like I have.
When you've crossed the deepest oceans and seen every distant shore,
then you know what happiness is.
Yes, you know what happiness is. But you wonder, isn't there something more?
When you've swum with the dolphins
like I have,
seen the Taj Mahal at sunrise,
shaking hands with Al Gore,
then you think you know what happiness can be.
But still you wonder, isn't there something more?
And then one day we were in the Andes and met a monk. And the monk told us about this seminar that some guy gives at a Holiday Inn in San Diego, where you walk over hot coals, and then he tells you the true secret of happiness.
So we flew to San Diego.
And they walked over hot coals.
And he told us,
you have to change your goals.
Life isn't only about you. You have to do something for other people. And we thought, huh. And then on our very next trip to the Himalayas, we met Harold. It was a terrible blizzard, but we could just make out this tiny figure all alone. He was starving and shaking. We pitched camp and nursed him back to health. And Harold made it. We all made it.
And we raised that Yeti child
and loved him as our own.
And we promised him he'd never be alone.
He'd have lots and lots of friends.
So we thought, where would he fit in?
And it turned out he's like freakishly good at hockey.
So we googled hockey,
and Google mentioned Minnesota.
And we thought, well,
that's our latest mountain. Minnesota is a mountain.
It's a flat metaphorical mountain.
So we moved here to lead normal lives.
And if Harry's good at hockey, he'll make lots of friends.
And he'll finally know what happiness can be.
And we too will know what happiness can be.
Until one day we wonder,
isn't there something more?